Hey, this is me, Uncle Ricky. Today, I gotta talk about the links people go to push their agenda. Yeah, it's political, but what the fuck else do I have to talk about? It's politics. Now, sometimes I do other shit, but the majority of what's being generated, which the majority of what's in anybody's news cycle today, is the insanity that's being generated in Washington, D.C. It's mostly Republicans because right now they're guilty of the most dastardly shit in our history. But Democrats do the same thing. And that's lie to support their agenda, to make it look like whatever I said is the right thing for us to do. Whatever comes down because it came from this body or because it came from this government, it's good for y'all. Because we said it's good for you. Sometimes that works. But most of the time, especially recently, when laws are being dictated not by the legislature, but by the judiciary, point in case the overturning of Roe versus Wade, we predicted the downside. We predicted the cases that would quickly pop up that they didn't consider. Or if they did consider, they just don't care because they want to have shit their way. They want to take us back. They want to turn us into something that the forefathers, as they so routinely like to call on, never fucking intended us to be. They took specific links to make sure that we did not end up as a religious governed country. Now, the point I'm going to make is the country is still up in arms over the Supreme Court basically overturning the right of women to control their own reproductive process just because it did not fit the viewpoint, not the law, it did not fit the viewpoint of the conservative majority on the Supreme Court. The thing that's crazy is the first thing that pops up is about the little 10-year-old girl in Ohio. This girl gets raped. She's pregnant. Her family wants her to have an abortion. The girl doesn't want to have a baby. How should a 10-year-old girl be forced to carry a child to term? Well, Ohio had a trigger law, so then as soon as the Supreme Court overturned Roe versus Wade, trigger law goes into effect, and now this child is ineligible for an abortion because she missed the 6-week cutoff by a couple of days. Before Roe versus Wade was overturned, it wouldn't have been a problem. She still could have sought an abortion, but by her living in Ohio, she couldn't get an abortion in Ohio. So her parents took her to Indiana. A doctor with good sense in Indiana performed the abortion. Now this should be the end of the case because they didn't break Ohio law, not as it's written now. And the doctor didn't do anything illegal by Indiana law. That's not good enough for these Republicans. When the story first broke, of course, they went into the denial mode because they didn't want the press to eat up the irony. They didn't want the press to basically and justifiably drag their raggedy asses through the mud. Thing being, they went into a lie campaign. First of all, they called the girl and her family liars. They said that she's not pregnant. It didn't exist. The Democrats are just, you know, propaganda, you know, socialist propaganda, liberal claptrap. It doesn't happen. So then guess what happens? The guy that committed the rape, or rapes, plural, gets caught and confesses. He mans up and confesses to the rape of a 10-year-old child. We're going to let that drop for a second. So now, we know it's not a lie. So all these motherfuckers that came out and, you know, they were shooting texts everywhere, text messages everywhere, high five, it's a lie. Now they don't remember shit. They don't remember saying this shit. It jumps over to Indiana has a Republican Attorney General. Now he does his own little bullshit lie, saying that the doctor didn't properly report the abortion, so he's going to go after her license. Now, mind you, along the way, they're dropping people's names. They're not trying to protect the privacy of a 10-year-old and her family. They're not trying to protect the privacy of the doctor who did not violate Indiana law, because they found where she filed all the appropriate paperwork reporting assisting the girl with a medical abortion, that means by pill, and she filed it within the required 3 days. She filed it on the second day. So where has she broken the law? But this Attorney General, this Republican Attorney General, is determined to find some way to legally persecute her for doing her damn job. Ohio Republicans are sending death threats to the family of a 10-year-old girl that they want to force, or they wanted to force her to carry a baby to full term, 10 years old. 10 years old. Who's gonna raise that child? At 10, you think her parents really were ready to raise their daughter's child at 10? You think they wanted to put their daughter through the aggravation and pain, suffering, and basically, yes, embarrassment of raising a child at 10 years old. This is the type of shit that these weird, crazy, conservative, right-wing, God, country, and us, this is the type of bullshit that they want to do to everybody. And they're the minority. It wouldn't be right if they were the majority, because it's oppressive bullshit that they're talking about. They're taking away the rights of the individual to conduct their lives by their own standards. It's the land of the free. That's what Americans always said it was. It's a lie, but it was closer to being the truth than it is today. Hard to believe. You know, abortion should be a personal decision. It's an option. It would be just as bad to legally mandate an abortion as it is to say that you can't have one. You motherfuckers got your way, and now that it's blowing up in your face, you scrambling, you hiding, you projecting, you deflecting, you denying. You can't have it both ways. You did it, it's gonna cause problems. You gotta deal with it. And you know what? I think the voters are going to make the Republican Party pay in this November election in a way that they didn't. They got high on their horse because they looked at how successful they have been in midterm elections when there was a Democratic president. This time, I think y'all crossed the line. I think y'all went overboard. The abortion thing, the failing to do anything about meaningful gun control. I'm not talking about banning guns. I'm talking about you always say that, you know, it's a mental health issue. But motherfuckers, if it's a mental health issue, which I agree, most of the motherfuckers that go out and do this crazy ass shit are crazy. Why not do something? Why not participate in the program? Make laws which you are charged to do by your position. You know, you Congress people, you senators in the United States government, in that branch of government called the legislative branch, y'all supposed to do shit to help this out. I don't think a total ban on guns is realistic, and I don't think it's necessary. But just like with an automobile, everybody can't drive a car. Just like with an automobile, you gotta pass some tests to make sure that you can drive. Just like with an automobile, there's age restrictions on when you can drive. No, it doesn't stop all of the deaths due to automobile accidents. But automobile accidents are not, for the most part, occur because of insane homicidal maniacs. If we didn't have any kind of restrictions at all, think of the chaos that would exist on our American highways. Speaking of chaos, in retrospect, I think these fools love chaos because that's what they're trying to supplant the Constitution with. I'm not going to say all of our laws are great laws, but at least that's what the country works by. This shit that they're doing, we can't continue to function. Well, that's it from Uncle Ricky's house for now. Till the next time, peace out. God bless. Oh, yeah. Subscribe. I know you're watching. Subscribe. I need that. Later.